あー疲れた。
どうしたの？
今日は本当に最悪だった。朝からお腹ピーピーだし、鳥に糞落とされたし、新しい靴でうんち踏んだし。
やばい、めっちゃウケる。めっちゃ運いいじゃん。
こんにちは。Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, welcome to Real Japanese Family. And thank you for coming into my channel. So today, I will teach you how to use し。し。So し actually has several meanings. So today, I'll be explaining in this order. Number one, し that means on top of that. On top of that. Number two, the difference between くてで and し。 Number three, し that means as well. As well. Okay, first, please watch a skit.
ミク、マルコくんって好きな人いるのかな？
え？アミ、マルコのこと好きなの？
ちょっと気になってる。この前、いきなり好きなタイプ聞かれたんだけど、なんでかな？
どうやったらアミちゃんはサトシのことが好きになるかな。あ、いいこと思いついた。
アミちゃん、久しぶりですね。こんにちは。あ、マルコくん、久しぶり。突然なんですけど、アミちゃんは好きな人がいますか？
え、今いないよ。
おお、なるほど。じゃあ、好きなタイプはどんな人ですか？
え？好きなタイプ？好きなタイプは、優しくて声が低い人かな。いきなりどうしたの？
いや、別に何でもないですよ。ただ、気になっただけです。
そっか。
マルコのこと気になってるの？マルコくん優しいし、笑顔も素敵だし、面白いし、あとめっちゃ話しやすい。
なるほどね。
Oh no, this is getting so complicated. Okay, the love triangle has started.
三角関係が始まったね。
If you haven't watched this series, please watch the season 1 so you know what's going on right now with Satoshi and Ami and Marco.Anyways, Ami-chan obviously likes Maruko now. And when she was talking about Maruko, she said,
Maruko-kun, 優しいし、笑顔も素敵だし、面白いし、あとめっちゃ話しやすい。
Do you know what this she means? This she basically means on top of that in English. Okay, so usage number one. You can use she when you give one fact.And add more information by listing multiple verbs, nouns, or adjectives. So by putting she after a word, you can express, it's not only this, but also this, and this, and this. So you can use this when you're talking about how amazing someone is, or something is, or how horrible something is as well. So in the skit, Ami said,
Maruko-kun wa yasashi shi,
he is kind,Not only that,
笑顔も素敵だし、
He has got nice smile. On top of that, 面白いし、He's funny. And あと
means also, めっちゃ話しやすい。
We already learned this 安い before, right? It means it's easy to do something. So 話しやすい is he is easy to talk to. So with e adjective, you just add し at the end. So Ami said,マルコは優しいし。So, 優しい is e adjective and you just add し、優しいし。And with na adjective, we need to put that before し. So, 素敵 means nice, neat, and it's a na adjective. So, she said, 素敵だし。素敵だし。We have to put that. And with a noun, we also have to put that before. So, for example, Ken is good looking and funny.Do you know how to say good looking casually in Japanese? Have you ever heard the word ikemen? Ikemen? So ike comes from iketeru, which means good or cool. And men comes from the English word men. So ikemen is a very casual and modern word, but people use it. Anyways, ikemen is a noun and it means a good looking guy. Ken is good looking and funny. You'd say, Ken wa ikemen da shi omoshiroi. Ken wa ikemen da shi omoshiroi. So be careful with na adjective and noun. You need to put that before she. Okay, so let's say you like Ami-chan, and how do you think you can say, Ami-chan is beautiful and mature. Ami-chan is beautiful and mature. And you are kind of expressing how amazing Ami-chan is. So do you know how to say mature in Japanese? It's otona ppoi. Otona ppoi. So otona means adult and otona ppoi means mature. If you want to say immature, it's kodomo ppoi. Kodomo ppoi. Anyways, how do you think you can say Ami-chan is beautiful and on top of that, not only that, not only she's beautiful and she's mature. It's Ami-chan wa kirei da shi otona ppoi. Ami-chan wa kirei da shi otona ppoi. And you might be wondering, what is the difference between Ami-chan wa kirei da shi otona ppoi and Ami-chan wa kirei de otona ppoi? So we learned before that when we connect e adjective, we use kute. And when we connect na adjective, we use de, right? So when you connect with kute and de, we are simply listing adjective. Like Ami-chan is beautiful and mature. It's very neutral, but when you say Ami-chan wa kirei da shi otona ppoi, I'm emphasizing that she's not only beautiful, but she's also mature. So it sounds like I'm emphasizing Ami is amazing. Okay, another example. Mexico has got good weather and it has got delicious food. And I'm talking how amazing Mexico is. I would say, Mexico wa tenki mo ii shi, ryori mo oishi. Mexico wa tenki mo ii shi, ryori mo oishi. And you might be wondering why I used mo particle here. You usually use ga particle and say, Mexico wa tenki ga ii. Mexico has got good weather. And ryori ga oishi, it has got delicious food. We usually use ga particle. But when we use shi and list lots of things, we change ga particle and o particle into mo particle. So I don't know if you guys have noticed, but in the skit, Ami said, Maruko-kun wa egao mo suteki da shi omoshiroi. Usually it's egao ga suteki. He has got good smile or he has got nice smile. But because we are using shi, ga particle changes into mo particle. Okay, for example, how do you think you can say Takahashi is intelligent and what's more, he's talented? Takahashi is intelligent and what's more, on top of that, he is talented. So intelligent is atama ga ii. Atama ga ii, right? Do you know how to say talented? It's sainou ga aru. Sainou ga aru. So sainou is talent and aru is to have. So how do you think you can say Takahashi is intelligent and what's more, on top of that, he is talented? You have to change ga particle into mo particle. It's Takahashi-san wa atama mo ii shi sainou mo aru. Takahashi-san wa atama mo ii shi sainou mo aru. So ga particle changes into mo particle. Of course, you can use shi when you talk about how horrible something is or how you don't like something. Okay, please watch a skit.
ああ、疲れた。どうしたの？今日は本当に最悪だった。朝からお腹ピーピーだし、鳥に糞落とされたし、新しい靴でうんち踏んだし。
やばい、めっちゃウケる。めっちゃ運いいじゃん。
うんち、うん、うんち、うん、うん、
うん、いいじゃん。
アミ、そんな日もあるって。じゃあ今日はパッと飲みに行こう。
Okay, so Ami was talking about how horrible her day was, right? First, she said,
朝からお腹ピーピーだし。朝からお腹ピーピーだし。
Okay, もしこの動画を食べながら見てたら、ごめんね。I'm sorry if you are watching this while eating. But onaka pee pee means to have diarrhea. You know, it's onomatopoeia when your poo is... Okay, I don't have to explain this to you. So, 朝からお腹ピーピーだし is like, from the morning, I have diarrhea. 鳥に糞落とされたし。鳥に糞落とされたし。So, 糞 is animal's poo, basically. And 落とされる is the passive voice of 落とす, which means to drop.If you don't know the passive voice, I already made a video about it, so please watch it later if you don't know passive voice. So basically, 鳥に糞落とされたし means a bird pooped on me, and on top of that, 新しい靴でうんち踏んだし。新しい靴でうんち踏んだし。So 踏む means to step on something. 新しい靴 new shoes, 新しい靴で with my new shoes,うんち踏んだし、step on the poo. I stepped on poo with my new shoes. So you can use she to express and almost exaggerate how bad things are as well. And as you can see, we can use this she with verbs as well. Like in the skit, 鳥に糞落とされたし and うんち踏んだし。So you can use she after a verb. For example,This hotel has a pool and has got gym as well. You can say, このホテルはプールもあるし、ジムもある。このホテルはプールもあるし、ジムもある。So, ある is a verb to have or to exist. And you can add she after a verb. The verb is usually plain form of the verb. Okay, for example, today I cleaned, I did laundry, and I also washed my car.You can say, 今日は掃除もしたし、洗濯もしたし、車も洗った。今日は掃除もしたし、洗濯もしたし、車も洗った。If you just want to say, today I did this and this and this, if you are expressing the order of your action, you can just use te form and connect the verbs. For example, 今日は掃除して、洗濯して、車を洗った。今日は掃除して、洗濯して、車を洗った。But if you want to express that you have done so much, like your day has been very productive, like I did this, and I did this, and on top of that, I did this, then you can use she to express you've done so much. Just one thing to be careful. When you want to say, for example, I went to Osaka and saw my friend,If you're expressing the order of your action, timeline of your actions, you need to connect with te form. So it's 大阪に行って友達に会った。I went to Osaka and I met or I saw my friend. You're expressing the order of your action. But for example, if I ask you, what did you do in Osaka? And you want to tell me you have done so much in Osaka, like I ate lots of Osaka food, I met Miku,I went to the Osaka castle as well. You can use she and say, 大阪料理もたくさん食べたし、ミクにも会ったし、大阪城にも行った。But again, if you're expressing the order of your action, like I did this, and after that I did this, and after that I did this, then use te form. So I explained that you can use she when you're talking about how amazing someone or some things are or how horrible things are as well. But we can use she in more neutral way as well. Okay, じゃあスキットを見てください。
ミク、今度お花見行こう？
いいよ、行こう。
いつ空いてる？
来週の金曜日も空いてるし、日曜日も空いてるよ。Okay, so I said,金曜日も空いてるし、日曜日も空いてる。金曜日も空いてるし、日曜日も空いてる。So, 空いてる means available. And here, it's not like I'm saying, I'm available on Friday and on top of that, I'm free on Sunday. I'm not really expressing on top of that. I'm simply saying, I'm free on Friday and Sunday as well. So, she can be translated as well or also in English.
例えば、We are going to a party and I ask you, ドレスで行った方がいい?
And you go, you can wear dress or casual clothes. You would say,
ドレスでもいいし、普段着でもいいよ。ドレスでもいいし、普段着でもいいよ。
Or if I ask you, who's coming to the party? And you go, Akiko is coming. And Saki is coming as well. You would say, Akiko も来るし、Saki も来るよ。Akiko も来るし、Saki も来るよ。So we use this she often when we are thinking and talking at the same time. Like adding the information like this and this as well. So if I wanna say Akiko and Saki are coming, and if I'm not thinking while speaking, then I would say Akiko to Saki ga kuru. Akiko to Saki ga kuru. But if I'm kind of thinking and adding the information, Akiko is coming, and also Saki is coming, then I would use she. Akiko mo kuru shi, Saki mo kuru yo. Like I'm thinking while speaking. For example, if I want to say, I can go on Saturday or Sunday. And I would say, 土曜日も行けるし、日曜日も行ける。土曜日も行けるし、日曜日も行ける。So you can use this she when you are simply listing and adding information after, like as well or also. Okay, so this is the part one video, but she actually also means because. So I'll be making part two video soon. If you want to watch a longer video with challenge time where I provide lots of example and PDF sheet to better understand this grammar,Please consider to be my $3 patron. If you're already my Samurai, Gokenin, Daimyo, Shogun patron, this is already included. So please go check out my Patreon page. I'm sorry for this change, but it takes more than 10 hours to make one video. So this includes writing script, filming, and editing. So I hope you understand this change. But I promise you guys, I will continue to work harder so I can provide more content for free. I'm so grateful for you all who are watching.This video and always supporting me Korean Japanese and always leaving kind comment. いつもありがとうございます。本当に感謝しています。 Okay, I'll see you in the next video. またねー